This is one of the example problem. Okay, you can neatly write on a book so that it will be helpful for you when I'm solving this question on the board.
All right, guys, read us this question quickly. Mr. Narayan, submit the following particulars of income from other sources for the year ended 31st March 2019 in our previous year, family pension from Government of Karnataka, yearly 42,000. See, family pension, I told you, pension received by an employee from their employer till he dies, it is called as a pension. And pension is taxable under the head income from salaries, but not from the income from other sources. But if the employee dies, and such pension is received by his spouse or his wife, that such pension is called as a family pension. And I told you, family pension is partly taxable and partly exempted. Now, how much is taxable and how much is exempted? That we need to understand here. First, I will write a family pension. Now, if you write here, computation of taxable family pension. See, what is the actual family pension received? Actual family pension received is 42,000, and we give exemption least of the following. Exempted least of the following. What are the least of the following here? First one is 1/3 of actual family pension received. What is the actual family pension received is 42,000. So 42,000 into 1/3, 14,000 rupees is the first least amount. And the second one is the maximum limit is 15,000 rupees, and whichever is less is exempted. Whichever is less in these two is 14,000 rupees is less. So therefore, we write 28,000 rupees. 28,000 rupees is taxable family pension. Now, we write 28,000 rupees here as a taxable pension, but not 42,000 rupees. Understood, guys? Okay, fine. Royalty from books written is 20,000, and in the brackets, expenses incurred for this purpose is 2,500. See, any royalty received as a author of the textbook, I am receiving 20,000 as a royalty. At the same time, in writing that book, I incurred 2,500 rupees expenses that has to be deducted, because always, when I have an income, definitely I will have an expenses also. So, in order to get my net income, I have to deduct my expenses from my gross income. So, therefore, I write it here as royalty received is 20,000 less expenses related to this is 2,500, and 17,500 is taxable under the head income from other sources. Remuneration from articles published in a magazine. See, I have written an article in a magazine or in a journal on a general topic, on a religion thing, or in a specific kind of a thing, giving a public awareness about some kind of a disease or something I have given. So, an article which I have written, for that I am receiving a remuneration. So, therefore, it is taxable remuneration for articles published, okay, 2,000 rupees, which is completely taxable under the head income from other sources. Next is, cash worth of 1 lakh rupees was found in her private locker or Ignace's private locker, this source of which could not be explained by him. See, actually, this is called as undisclosed source of income. So, undisclosed means what? Unaccounted money. This source of income is not properly explained by him. So, therefore, we can write undisclosed income. See, it is not disclosed this income. So, 1 lakh rupees is fully taxable under the head income from other sources. Next is interest on fixed deposits. Interest on fixed deposits, which we have already discussed, gross means full amount we have to write. Gross means full. Before deducting the taxes he was given, so therefore we are writing completely 15,000 rupees is taxable. Rent from subletting the house. See, rent from subletting. See, rent from subletting is taxable under the income from other sources, because here the person who is in the house for rent purpose, okay, he himself is a tenant, and a portion of the rented premises is subletted to someone. See, he himself is a tenant, he paying rent for the house, and he subletted a portion of the rented premises to third party. Now, if he is subletted for more excess rent than the actual rent, so which is taxable. Now let us see here. See, he subletted the house property for 1500 rupees per month. Now I will write it here, computation of taxable subletting portion. Say rent for subletting, how much is charging? 1500 per month. For 12 months it becomes 18,000 rupees. And further what is given? Actually rent paid to the owner is 1000 rupees per month for the subletting portion. This is the rent charged for subletting portion. And actual rent paid to owner is 1000 rupees per month. That means 12,000 rupees subletted portion, he is subletted for 18,000 rupees. And repair expenses for the subletting portion he incurred is 200 rupees. So totally 12,200 rupees was actual his expenses for the subletting portion, which he is subletted for 18,000 rupees. So thereby 5,800 rupees is the income which is charged excess to the third party which is subletted. Okay. Next is winning from lottery and purchase of lottery 100. See here, winning from lottery, we know that it is a casual income. See, I told you, if any income from casual incomes, like winning from lottery, winning from horse race, winning from card games, winning from any kind of a gambling, okay, on all such casual incomes, okay, the payer of the benefits, the lottery service people, okay, they deduct 30% of taxes from their income and they pay the rest of the money to the winner. Understood? The authorities of the lottery authorities, they deduct 30% of taxes and they pay 70% of the income to the winner of the lottery. That means if it is a net income, okay, see, this is all we call it as a grossing up of income. Hope all of you have taken this. I'm erasing this, okay, because I need to explain to you about casual income. See, he won the lottery, okay. See, the gross income we don't know. From this, he has deducted taxes is 30%. Suppose if this is gross income is 100% and tax is 30% and 70% is the net income. Right? So this is called as a net income. Whenever he is given a net income, we need to gross up. We need to know what is the gross income which he has earned. Now, in this question, winning from lottery, net is given. So, net amount of income from lottery is 70,000. So, net is equals to how much? 70. What is for 100% of gross income? Now, this will come to 1 lakh rupees. So, whenever there is a net, 4 point is there. Net casual income is given, we need to gross up. Okay, so you know how to gross income. Say always if you take gross income is 100 rupees and casual income, only this is for casual income and tax is 30% and your net income will be 70%. If in the question, if he is given net income, what is the net income he received which is equals to 70, what is for 100, we have to calculate. Next is winning from horse race 35,000. Again, net amount is given. Winning from horse race 35,000. Net is for 70, meaning to gross up, which comes to 50,000. Now, that's all about the points here. We need to calculate income from other sources. 1, 11, 20, 28, 7, 8, 9, 11, 3. Say 3,18,300, this is income from other sources. Okay, guys. So this is a second question for 6 marks. Okay?